Fayette County's SPC Hanover 8947 here along with Mrs. Clark. Go ahead, Mrs. Clark.
The time is 6:38. The temperature is 66.0 degrees Fahrenheit. The time is 6:38 a.m. The temperature is 66.0 degrees Fahrenheit.
And real temperature is about 70, 71 degrees in here. Because I don't have the real temperature pulled up anymore. But as we as promised, here's an early morning video of pretty much what I'm going to do here while getting ready for school. Unfortunately, I'm back to where I need to miss the required weekly test. So yeah, I'm going to have to miss the required weekly test again. I'm not going to be getting one for a while until summer break, which is going to be a long time. It's only January. If the only time could go quick, that would be great. But anyway, what we could do right now is we pretty much need to switch every radio to voice for the weekly required weekly test. This thing here. Oh, now I played over the volume. Now I need to wait for the saving thing to go. That thing likes to activate really late for the weekly test. I don't like it, and I don't know why it does it, but it does. Because, basically, this is the AlertWorks EAR10's first required weekly test. So, basically, this will go off first for it. Then the AJ's will go off. The 400 and the 300 will probably go off together, both together. And this was the really late one. So, yeah. I just want to wait until the 120 goes with the saving thing, which it needs to get out because it's already been sitting in there for about 30, almost a minute. Hello, excuse me, can you please, thank you. Now, we're not doing any alert testing this time of day. I'm going to have to do it with the 300 though because I'm going to be turning the siren level to high. So, hello, 120, I pressed the menu button, thank you. We're gonna put that to voice.
The National Weather Service, Kent State College.
Oh, don't. It can get WXM42, but now this is on voice. Now we're gonna do the we are gonna do the 400. And put that on voice for the weekly test today. So, basically, I'm just gonna put all these radios on voice. See, the 400 doesn't have as bad menu lag as the 120 does. Excuse me. And only gets WXL40. So now, what we need to do is we need to go to 300 and turn the voice indicator on. I don't know if you can see it, but 120, if this thing will actually want to do something for once. Maybe turning on a light would work. There you go. I don't know if you guys can see that well, but the voice thing is on. Oh, and now it's not wanting to focus on it. Oh well. But the voice thingy is on. Now I need to turn on the 300 to voice. Oh wait, I already passed it. Whoops. Oh, it is on voice. But that's the only alert. Siren and voice is the only thing on here. Bleh. Okay, so now I'm gonna turn the siren to high. It's gonna get loud. How loud would the siren be now? Oh, okay, holy moly. Alright, yeah. It does get loud. It should activate for the weekly test now. Now, we're gonna do the HH now. For some reason, this did not sound the alert tone for the weekly test. Why didn't it? Okay, so you 3.
Lows in the upper 20s.
WXM 42.
Below skies.
Now we need to do the alert type and put that. And yes, I did press the select button because as you can see now, the voice thingy on YouTube is on. And here we come to the newest radio in the family. That's right. The AlertWorks EAR-10. So now we need to turn this to voice. Actually, let's make sure the weekly test is actually on. Whoop. Yep, good. Record weekly test is on. Now, what we can do... Alert type. That's what we wanted on. So basically, now the AlertWorks EAR-10 is now ready for the required weekly test. Hopefully it actually sounds its siren for it. See, if raising the antenna, excuse me. It probably can't get anything. Which is my only demonstration I have for you to show you that it can't get anything else except WXL-40. Maybe it's because my sister put tape on the antenna, which I didn't like. There's WXM42. This thing sucks at getting it. That's probably because my sister put tape on the antenna, but I did not like it. So, now we're just gonna put the antenna back down. But anyway, there's the AlertWorks EAR-10, which is the newest radio of the family. Basically, there's the HH. So, basically, this is pretty much every early morning video I'm making here. Yeah. Oh yeah, don't we forget to flip through the channels here on the 300? Yes, we did. Let's do that, quick. I need to make sure that these radios here are on the correct channel. WXM42. Alright, now we're gonna switch the light off and see what happens. Yeah. Thank you. There it is. WNG704. And so basically, it can't get anything else except for WNG704 and WXM42, and somewhat WNG704. So it can get WXK97. But anyway, let's just make sure all these are on WXL40. That's on WXL40. That's on WXL40. That's on WXL40.
Chance of snow 30%.
That's on WXL40. And let's check on the 400 to make sure it's on WXL40 as well.
Their normal precipitation.
Good. They are on WXL40. So they will all activate for the weekly test because when it goes off, I think the EAR-10 goes off on the headers. So this will go off first. This will hopefully go off with a siren next. The 400 and the 300 will go off together. And here is the late one. This is the one that likes to activate really late for the weekly. So, basically that's what's happening right now. I don't know if I should, if you saw the date. It is January 6th, 2021. So, basically that's it. Let's see what... Oh, okay. Okay.
Have no fear, Captain.
So, okay, well, that was basically it. I don't really want to go into much detail on what's going on around here, because I'm getting ready for school, obviously. See what the 400 is getting right now. They're on commercial. And they're on music, too. And that's pretty much it. Oh yeah, let's check the AM band. WLW is starting to go away. It's starting to get light out here, so... They're WCBS, but anyway. Let's see what the 300 can get before we hop off here. It's getting 15:30 still. It gets WSBA. And it gets WHAS. Nice. Oh, it's making a siren thing too. And WHAS. Probably can't hear it, but it is making a siren thing on WHAS. So basically that's what's happening right now. So I hope you have enjoyed this Wednesday morning. I hope all of these required weekly I hope the required weekly test goes out and all of these things go off for it. Hopefully this thing especially goes off for it, since I care about it and I don't want the check reception thing going across the screen and beeping at me. Because that's what happens if it doesn't receive the required weekly test. It starts doing that. Because this thing is late at getting it. Why are you always late at getting required weekly tests? You literally now activate when the required weekly test is over. You guys, all the rest of you, activate on the 8-second beep or whatever you call that thing. While the 120 gets wait until the end of the message to activate. So that's all I have to say. Oh yeah. And there's the 120 without a faceplate, because I broke the faceplate, but at least it still works. Carson, I believe, he's from Texas. He films EAS alerts from Texas. He has a 120 that's like that, so. I hope you have enjoyed. And that'll be it. Have a great day, everybody.